Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this Motion in Two Dimensions problem, they tell us that there is this Ferris wheel, and they took an image from the book chapter. And in the book, they gave us an example of how to get the acceleration vector from right here at the rightmost point. They want us to use the same thing to figure out ones from right here on the left side, and then the top and the bottom. I'll use a different color to represent what we're going to do here, but what they talked about in the book is that we're finding the change in the velocity to get the acceleration vector. If you remember, acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over the change in time. Here we're using a graphical representation to find the change in the velocity. So if we say this is our initial velocity for this point right here, and then this is the final velocity vector for this point right here, we'll take this delta v, which is the same thing as v final minus v initial, and we'll subtract the two. But whenever you subtract a vector, you take the one that you're subtracting by and you flip it backwards, and then you go tip to tail, and then you find the resultant vector. So this one, let's take it and we'll turn it backwards, and now we'll slide it up here, and we'll keep the exact same orientation like that. And this is the exact same vector like we just said, we just moved it up here. And now we draw the resultant vector. So this blue arrow is representing the acceleration vector, which is the difference between these two vectors. So you can see that around a circular arc or circular motion, the acceleration vector is pointed towards the center of the circle. So let's do the same thing like the question talks about for the leftmost point. So this is the initial velocity, this is the final velocity. So we'll take the initial and turn it backwards, and then we'll move it to the tip of this one right here, the final, and then we'll draw it the exact same as it is right here. So we just slid it over. And now we'll draw the resultant vector, which you can see, of course, is going towards the center. Doing the same thing for the top, we'll do this one right here. So this is the initial and this is the final. So the initial, we'll just turn it backwards and then we'll slide it up here. It's going like that. So it's also pointed towards the center of the circle. And then we'll do the same thing down here on the bottom. Obviously, my circle isn't super circular, but it is a pretty good representation to show what we're doing. So we'll pick this point for the one of the bottommost points. This is the initial, this is the final. So we take the initial, draw it backwards, and then slide it. The tail of this one goes to the tip of this one, like so, and then that is pointed to the center of the circle there. So you can see that if we did this for all of them would be pointing towards the center of the circle, which goes to show you how acceleration is pointing towards the center, because the change in the two, just like the mathematical representation of it, gives us the acceleration. So the blue arrows are the acceleration for the highest, lowest, left, and right points on this Ferris wheel.